Let's check 15 games on new MacBook Air with M1 chip, my version with 16 gigs of RAM, and I don't want to use different tweaks, emulators like crossover, so it will be a clean gaming experience. I sorted all games in 4 different categories. Excellent performance, good performance, bad performance, and game doesn't work. So, let's check it out. Let's dive into excellent performance, and starting with games with really big pixels. Into the Breach, just perfect. A cool game for little breaks with unique game design. Highly recommended for you guys, so this is a masterpiece. Dead Cells. Game doesn't have graphic settings at all, it's work perfect with controller support. The Pedestrian. Works great at 60 FPS and maximum graphic quality. I have a problem with my controller, it doesn't work. According to Steam page, it should be, but I don't know, it doesn't work. But the game works just fine. RimWorld, stable 60 FPS at native Mac resolution. Works perfect even at high game speed. I found only one glitch, but it's not critical. Diablo 3, really smooth gameplay. The biggest surprise for me is the loading time of location. It takes a moment, you know, not a second, not a minute, a moment. Native resolution with medium-high graphic settings give you stable 60 FPS. Doesn't work with a controller at all, even at Windows PC. HearthStone, well, you know, even a bad potato could launch this game. And GRIS, it's perfect, that's all. And jumping to a good performance. Disco Elysium. At medium quality and native Mac resolution, game works between 30 to 60 FPS at all time. This isn't critical for this type of games when you pay almost all of your attention at text. A lot of really fun text. Crusader King 3. You can play it at native resolution on low settings very well. It shows not a good performance, but 20 to 30 FPS at all time, and I think this is okay for this game. Main problem is high battery consumption. 1 hour of playing can kill around a half of your battery, so play it while you plugged in. City Skyline, at native resolution and on low graphic settings, you can get stable 30 FPS. And you can't increase it up to 60 FPS, the game doesn't allow to do this. But I think this is okay for this type of game, like building simulator. And coming to a bad performance. First of all, CSGO. It was a big surprise that CSGO works not well. Game uses really old OpenGL architecture and it doesn't optimize for Apple Silicon. Every launching was a pain in the butt. First of all, you need to set specific properties for game startup, because you couldn't go further the first cinematic video. You can play only using resolution 1280x800 in window mode, and on very low settings you can get stable 60 FPS. But first few minutes of new match have annoying micro freezes. Even main menu works at 30-40 FPS at all time. As for me, this is unplayable result, because you need stable frame rate at all time in this competitive type of games. XCOM 2. At native resolution and very low graphic settings, you can achieve only 15-20 FPS at all time. Also, I found a big trouble with fonts. Even at native resolution, it's look terrible. On lower resolution, frame rate doesn't increase at all. I think this is unplayable on Apple Silicon. Inside. This game works strange. You have stable 60 FPS, but you can't set appropriate resolution. Game thinks that native resolution is 1440x900, so you have a blurry image at all time. And Civilization 6 has some problem. I think this is because games can't understand specifications of your system, like what GPU or what display your system has. This is why you have this low maximum resolution. By the way, game works good. Even on ultra settings, it shows in average 30 FPS at 1440x900. About this game, I don't worry about graphic settings, I want to play at native Mac resolution, or at least close to this value. Really good performance, but it has this critical resolution issue. and the final part the game doesn't work. Here is one game, Celeste, it doesn't work, it just crashed when you launch it. This is a version of Epic Games Store and I found a solution for Steam version, but it doesn't fit to Epic Game version. By the way, Epic Game Store works like a piece of garbage on M1, maybe on whole macOS itself. A lot of games have macOS support in Steam, but you can't launch it using Epic Game Store. For example, Darkest Dungeon, For the King, The Escapists. Don't use Epic Game Store at all if you want to play on your Mac. Maybe only for Fortnite, that's okay. I can say that all games have two separate ways. First way is to work perfect, smooth gameplay, 60 FPS, high quality. Mwah. Second way is doesn't work at all. But M1 chip was the final reason why I left my lovely Windows machine. So what do you think about these gaming results? Leave a comment below and I hope you like this video because this is my first try in English YouTube. Yeah. Wow, it's really scary. Очень страшно, очень больно, но я все-таки пробую. Leave a comment below, thumbs up, hit the bell, subscribe and all this other stuff I don't want to remind. See you, увидимся, до свидания and good luck with with the game on M1 chip, because this is great. This is a cool performance in this little type text typing machine. So, it's cool. Goodbye.